Hello everyone, welcome to Halo Moon Tarot. This is your weekly reading for Capricorn. How are you guys? So this is any aspect of your life, take it how it best resonates. I'm also wanting again to add some more changes to my channel, but I thought before I switch things up drastically, I would ask you guys what it is you want. I would like to do a you versus them every couple of weeks or so, or even every week if that's what people want. Most people are interested in relationships, and I know people often ask, they want money readings, and I have done like a money reading for every sign before, and literally it was a lot of work and hardly anybody watched them. So that's why I often just kind of look to see what's in the weekly readings. But again, because most people on the channel, I hardly hear much about money other than people are looking for a job or hoping for another job, you know, things like that. So, yeah, I mean, you guys got to let me know what it is you want here, okay? Because I'd like to bring in some changes. I feel it's time. Maybe different spreads. Let me know, okay? So, all right, Capricorn, let's focus on you. It's all about you now. Capricorn, what is it you need to know? Yeah, I see an Emperor energy here. A lot of Emperor energies, yep, an Empress and a King of Wands. Oh, my goodness. Let me just pull out the other cards. What does Capricorn need to know? We got some Taurus energy here as well. Aries, Leo, Sag, Pisces. Lots of Pisces energy. So there's a lot of introspection. A lot of keeping it all in. I feel we got two people just keeping it all in. It's an energy of two people who it has to do with being on the same page here. So I like it. It's an energy of the Hierophant. So this is some sort of spiritual union here. I got to tell you, like this is... We got this person right here, and I do feel it's connected with the Emperor. So somebody here, you know, going through a bit of an awakening, definitely, you know, waking up to spirit, trusting their intuition. But I feel what happened at some point, somebody didn't. So, yeah, because I feel like we have this King of Wands energy, someone who generally knows what they want and goes for it. But it's somebody here looking at things from a different perspective. See, somebody made some sort of choice, decision or something, and it obviously wasn't the right choice or decision. But now we have this person, see, they're pulling back, looking for things different, little Sag energy. They're looking at things differently. This is someone who often feels something is off, but actually something here, I mean, this is an Emperor and Empress. It's the start of something new. So this is a feminine energy open to offers, ideas. Now, this is someone here who maybe feels something is off or vice versa. See, it's both people. This is going to be one of those readings. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's an energy of someone being patient. So this is two people very much the same, but yet just enough different to create some kind of balance. But we have a person just taking a pause. They're looking at this differently after a period of time. Someone's seeing everything completely different. It's a masculine seeing the Empress. Definitely some, it could be someone who's different than their usual type, and it could be vice versa too, but it is the King of Wands. I mean, it could be the Empress, you know, being open to somebody different, kind of pulling back after a period of time, feeling differently. It has to do with someone's type, whether someone's someone type or not. Yeah, and it, I would have to say probably yes. So let's have a look at the Emperor. Yeah, Aries, Leo, Sag energy, but it's just energy. It's an energy of being bold, but someone's keeping it all in. They're keeping something to themselves here. See, they're just kind of checking things out, just kind of going within. Yeah, someone having an introspection, they're going, aha. This is someone coming up with an idea, but it's also someone seeing things in a different light, seeing someone in a whole new light here. And it could be even to do with themselves. Yeah, you can see some sort of change. Yeah, some kind of change. It's definitely, you know, very positive energy. It's an energy of just kind of going with the flow, kind of seeing what happens. Yeah, I see getting out, socializing, going. Some of you may be going somewhere different, okay? But this could be someone in your social circle, your world around you. So, like I say, it's somebody, I feel there's a message here for some of you. When you're out and about, Look around you. Okay? It just popped into my head. Look around you. Someone's checking you out. So it's that someone looking at someone looking away, possibly too. This person's kind of going, aha. See, something felt a little off, but it's actually just right because, yeah, you can see what's happening here. We have the Empress. Yeah, it's an energy of somebody who, I see momentum, busy, a lot of people talking. Everyone's talking. It's a busy time, some kind of celebration or gathering. So this is someone looking at someone. And all of a sudden, we have this person taking a pause. And they're looking around. And the other person turns and looks at them. And now this person's, there's something about this person's going, aha, about. Because I do feel that somebody, it has to do with movement, making a move, some sort of momentum. Yeah, see, it's an energy of the one, the spark. See, this is someone going, aha, there was a spark. So this is someone who possibly feels something was off originally with someone. Now they feel there's this spark, this attraction. They're focused on the wand. They're, you know, very attractive. There's an attraction here. This is someone in your social circle. Now, this is also someone who wants to talk and communicate. They want to get someone alone. Yeah, because they're sensing something is off. Their intuition saying, what's going on here? Yeah, and this is it. Like I say, is this we know the Empress is someone who, the feminine wild, someone who, you know, maybe acting a little coy or something. And this person's picking up on something here. Let's have a look at the High Priestess. See, it's keeping it all in. It's keeping it all to themselves, not saying anything. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's the Emperor energy. See, this is someone just keeping it all to themselves. They're not saying anything, but they know the truth too. They know there's a spark, but that's that win or lose, right? They're coming in. This person's coming in. Yeah, look at that harmony and balance, wise counsel. This person's wise. Okay, they could even be talking to people here, trying to find something out. But I feel for most of you, they're keeping everything to themselves. Privacy, it's about being private. They want to talk alone. But I feel it. Maybe it didn't happen. But like I say, it's about harmony, something just right. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Something this person, I see someone who's like, feels like they kind of need to hurry up, but it's like everyone's talking and then they just pause. So I don't know if everybody paused and looked and noticed something. Two people looking at each other, that's what I feel, checking each other out. See, something about justice and harmony. There could be married people here too. So I don't know if this is someone married getting caught checking someone else because they're attractive. I'm going to find out. Tell me about the Emperor. What does this person want? Yeah, they're trying to manifest. See, they have all the information. They know. Very wise. This is someone gathering up info. They have everything they need and they know. This person knows. So there's going to be some kind of communication. Mm-hmm. Tell me more about this wise counsel. Yeah. So it's an energy of somebody letting go of their burdens, but it's about responsibility, reliability. See, this is somebody who relies on themselves to figure things out. They're not relying on what other people have to say. Yeah. Because it has to do with balance and harmony. Yeah. See, it's an energy of reliability. What's reliable? Someone seeing someone a whole different light. Like, tell me about the Empress. It could be the feminine in that energy as well, or both of you. Yeah, see, this is someone feeling left out in the cold. See, this is someone feeling left out in the cold, being ignored. So I don't know if you ignored this person or they were ignoring you. But it's all, you know, it's that energy of some sort of lack. This is somebody finding something out. Getting some kind of advice possibly, but I feel this is someone who relies on themselves to figure stuff out. And they're going, aha, they're seeing things in a whole different light. So there's no lack. See, there was some sort of negative, this person had negative thoughts here. The self-fulfilling prophecy though, you can see, See, it has to do with being on the same page, two people getting each other. Someone is just not getting something, but they're getting it now. So I feel like maybe ignoring someone, ghosting them, or just someone feeling left out. See, on the outside looking in, somebody felt left out. I feel this is maybe the feminine was left out, or this person's leaving someone out. It's like someone's talking to everybody, but the emperor or the empress here, being left out of the conversation. An outsider. Yeah, this is someone who's definitely stable, seeing them in a different light. So I don't know if this is somebody, someone told somebody this person, didn't have a whole lot of money, or they were lack or lonely or whatever happened, but they're finding out truth, and win or lose, they will find out the truth. Yeah, this is somebody, like I say, very strict, structured, self-discipline. This is someone with a lot of self-discipline. But you can see this person's, there's some pride in ego, somebody who provides. See, this is someone thinking someone is look chasing after someone. This is someone who's not chasing. In fact, this person may have ghosted or ignored this person. Now they're seeing it different because it has to do with providing, planning, preparing for success. This person's successful. See, they're seeing it in a different light. They're finding out some truth. Pretty common energy though. This is what happens when people are too hasty to judge. Yeah, somebody quick, too quick. Judging somebody quickly is what I feel, but they're now seeing the truth. Yeah, someone planning, preparing for success. See, it wasn't successful. This is somebody who wanted to connect, wanted to talk to someone, maybe even alone. I mean, there's a spark. There's definitely where someone looks away and then the other person kind of ignores them. Yeah, this is someone acting aloof, but this is also an energy of the Empress, somebody who, it's a person who I feel just felt ghosted, ignored. If someone ghosted you, ignored you at some point, now they're seeing things different. Why would you give them any kind of attention? That's so I, like I say, this is someone's pride here, ego. It has to do with someone who is seeing truth. This is someone who's successful. They don't need anyone to provide for them. Yeah, you see that? Look at that. See, going down this path. So this is someone acknowledging. See, they're acknowledging. See, someone didn't acknowledge this person. Now they're not acknowledging them. Not acknowledging them. Not acknowledging whatever. And I mean, it could be someone who said something in this, and it looks like there's people around too. I don't know if this is public, but I see this as someone private. Maybe wanting to talk in private, because I am seeing it. But this is how someone's conducting themselves. It has to do with someone who's, has faith in themselves here. Or someone here, like I say, it has to do with whether someone was faithful. Yeah, no, this is someone just kind of, I feel this is someone who has faith in themselves to find out what this is, to find out the truth. But I feel they already have. They're trusting in themselves here, not so much what other people say. Because at first this is someone feeling something is off. Now they're things are kind of calming down. It looks like it was busy, a lot of talk and chatter, lot going on. But it has to do with this person making a move. Maybe they were just kind of sitting there waiting, somebody waiting for someone to make a move. Well, nobody was making a move here, I can tell you that. Because it keeping it all in, keeping it to themselves, but it has to do with privacy. This is somebody private, so they're kind of getting it. Someone's getting it. Yeah, there's that King of Wands again. See, acknowledging. They have all the information. They have everything they need to manifest their desires. This is just the person that they want too. This is the person, everything they need. It's what two people bring to the table. So someone's finding out some truth here. Yeah. Look at that. See, this is some truth. This is someone awfully kind, compassionate, and forgiving. See, someone looking at things from a different perspective. Something that this person felt hopeful about. But, the Queen of Cups is someone who's definitely self-care, self-nurturing, someone who takes care of themselves. But it's also a person who's kind, compassionate. But this could be someone else checking. See, there's other people watching, I feel. This is a motherly figure, somebody watching this energy. They're seeing what's going on between two people. So I imagine there's a lot of talk. What are they all talking about? Let's see. Yeah. See, if someone's single. See, talking, this person's single, enjoying the fruits of their labor. They take care of themselves. They look good. They look single. But it's also someone who acts like they're not interested. They probably are. I mean, it looks like they are. But it's an energy of someone, like I say, being all the wiser here, looking at the way someone's communicating or the way they're behaving. Just like I say, focused on work, other things going on in their life. But you can see this lack. It's just somebody feeling left out. Or maybe this is somebody who got left out of the conversation. But I think it's this person got left out of talking to the Queen of Pentacles, the feminine. They didn't get a chance to talk. That's what it is. Because everybody was talking. And they're talking about someone who's single. They take care of themselves. They look great. They look good. Yeah, look at that. Capricorn. Yeah, someone very sexy, very charming, but very focused, driven, someone ambitious. So, and very creative too. So interesting. But it's like there's the everyone talking here. Yeah, I see there's somebody who's a friend, somebody in that social circle talking to somebody else. Maybe they were talking to this person, maybe because they're thinking about this. They're thinking about why didn't they talk to me? Why were they ignoring me? Because of something maybe that they did, because it looks like there's already some kind of history between two people here. See, gathering info, wanting to know someone's history. They're wanting to know things. And you can see someone putting on the brakes, taking another look. I feel there's a person in this social circle. I mean, this could be in your own energy, and it does look like people are talking, being sexy, charming, hardworking, very creative, someone who looks good, takes care of themselves, very independent with this energy. Yeah, a lot of that for feminine energy these days. But you can see someone putting on the brakes, taking another look. I think everybody was watching two people, some kind of exchange where nothing was said, but it was like everyone's talking and all of a sudden the talking stops. That's what it looks like. If this hasn't happened, it may play out this way. You could be with the Queen of Pentacles getting a heads up. Okay. Yeah. And I do see, like I say, looking around. Someone kind of looking around, putting on the brakes in a conversation. And looking around. See, this has to do with control. Someone's trying to control the conversation or something. And it's like they wanted to connect, talk, or talk alone, and they never got the opportunity. So very common energy, really. I mean, when you go out socializing with people, so somebody walks into a room, someone puts on the brakes and looks, they look around at this person and notice everybody's watching them. I'm hoping it isn't someone who's already in a committed relationship. But we have the King and Queen of Wands here and the Emperor and the Empress. These two are two people who've mastered life. See, this is, there it is, looking around. See, the conversation stops. Someone walks in, someone's head snaps around and looks. So, oh my, what happened? Tell me about the balance. Yeah, this person's very curious. See, they're learning. They've just learned something. They were curious. They wanted to know. They may have even asked people something about someone's history, their life, what they do for work. But they now have learned something. They now see they've learned something. They now have all the tools. They have the information. So they're kind of just looking at how to use this. Yeah, they want to reach out. They're not sure the other person will reciprocate though. I feel this is someone who, this person, somebody reached out. I mean, it could be this person took the lead and tried to reach out to someone and the other person ghosted and ignored them. So this is why they feel this is someone acting that way. They don't want to talk. They're not interested. But there's somebody here. Like, I mean, this could be part of the Empress energy, someone being kind, compassionate, something that could be forgivable, someone forgiving somebody. Maybe this person's finding that out too, because there's that hanged man again. See, taking a pause, someone going, aha. I'm trying to come up with some kind of idea here, something different. Yeah, they're going to try something different here. This is just an energy that's been going on for a while. I don't know what the planets are doing to do this, but I see this for a lot of people in similar ways. So it's all about that. People who want to connect, but they don't want to make it obvious, especially with a bunch of people around. And that's what I kind of feel is happening. The privacy, keeping it all in, you see. But someone's intuition's going, I see, aha, okay, I got it now. I got the information. I get it. So this is someone with a lot of skills, too. They're very capable. They have a lot of skills. They actually are someone who would bring something to the table. But I can see all this energy of the things you have in common. So, I mean, it's almost like maybe they stopped. Everyone stops talking. And maybe this person's listening. This person could be listening to something as well. And they learned something. This is really interesting. I doubt I'll be able to put my finger on all this because it's like it's not meant to be known here. But you can see this person taming the beast, being, you know, husky with confidence. Somebody had a lack of confidence. Maybe that's what they think. They don't feel confident. It's possible. But it's also someone who wants someone who comes in that way. There was definitely some kind of history, something negative of someone ignoring someone, ghosting them, or someone thinking somebody wasn't stable financially or chasing someone for the wrong reasons. But if someone's pride and ego is getting in the way too. See, it has to do with someone's pride and ego getting in the way. It's the Emperor, and I mean, maybe the Empress too, but... Yeah, and you can see, this is somebody walked away. See, the other person walked away. This is what this person's been searching for, this type of person, this person. Like I say, you might even know each other, but because I do see maybe some sort of history between the two of you, but it's a person wanting to know. I mean, there was some sort of an agreement, or they're cluing in. There was some kind of agreement here because this person was getting ready to communicate and then someone walked away. And this is a person feeling perplexed too. So trying to figure it out. Someone giving someone some advice. Yeah, this is someone, some sort of an agreement, someone giving someone advice to just walk away. Yeah, taming the beast, teaching someone how they want to be treated here too. Someone here, I feel someone's telling someone, yeah, because of the way maybe they treated you this way. And it has to do with someone not feeling very confident. But I see forgiveness. I see somebody quite forgivable. Yep, see, there was a date. Some of you had a date or there was a history. Or they, like I say, it's a curious, but someone was listening. Who was listening and what did they hear? Because see, something's off. That's why I feel like all of a sudden everyone stops talking. Page of Swords. There's a reason for this. Yeah, this is someone waiting to talk to get someone alone, waiting for a situation. See, they waited. This person was waiting to talk to someone to get them alone. And I feel this feminine maybe even tried to get this person alone, but they were never alone. Someone was never alone. Someone was keeping them busy. The heck is going on here? But I feel like this, you know, coming in, asking for a date, communication. And I feel someone's telling someone, just tell them the truth. It's an energy of truth. Yeah, just speak the truth. But it's likely someone giving some kind of motherly advice. Ask them out on a date. Why don't you ask them out? See, it's a date, courting, doing things in a more traditional manner. You know, somebody's morals, values, the way they conduct themselves. Somebody with very good morals, values, kind and compassionate. You know, someone who works, they take care of themselves. Now someone's, see, fantasizing and romanticizing here. Yeah, this is could be the feminine too, because we know the Queen of Pentacles often is in that energy of just looking at a situation and kind of fantasizing and visualizing yourself with this person. So I don't know if it's two people who got caught maybe even staring at each other, checking each other out. It's like heads snapped around, and they had to with the Chariot. This is someone who walks into the room very confident, you see. But that is someone taking their power back too. Someone's ego took a bit of a hit here, because this is, like I say, there's a history between two people. This is someone who took their power back. This is someone in control now. Yeah. You can see someone taking a little Aries energy for some, or Scorpio. I mean, I feel like it's yourself here, Capricorn, just in that energy of taking, being bold. Because, and I feel this is something that happened a while ago, because I did see this in a reading for you a while back where you were, and I did actually look at the planetary energy, and it was an energy of being bold and taking the lead. But for some reason, maybe you decided to wait and put on the brakes here. Because it has to do with taking a risk. Because we know the Queen of Pentacles always calculates the risk. So maybe it was too risky with people around. So somebody's backing off a bit. Yeah, maybe it didn't quite happen. Yeah, it's going to happen, though, because there's someone telling someone to just speak up and speak the truth. Yeah, this is someone stable. See, it's all happened at some place. Somebody with a lot of wisdom, trusting their inner knowing too. See, somebody here who knows. It's an energy of asking someone on a date, and that's what this person's saying. Yeah, see, an offer, an invitation. That's what this feminine's waiting for it. Yeah, ask them out. Someone's saying, just ask them out already. And then we got the person feeling a little, yeah, now we have this Emperor feeling a little shy. Not so sure what to say. Suddenly they're tongue-tied and they don't know what to say. Or they could, like I say, feeling a little insecure, suddenly feeling a little insecure. Maybe they feel it's the feminine who's insecure. This is someone confident. So maybe it's the feminine suddenly feeling insecure, feeling bold at one point, now took the lead, now suddenly feeling a little uncertain here. And it could be because this person maybe ghosted or ignored, or I don't know. There's just an energy of lack of confidence. See, it has to do with an invitation to someone's home, some sort of invitation to a home. And there's going to be, I mean, it does look like it could be the feminine here. Someone telling someone, you know, but I feel it has to do with, I feel it's the masculine. Mm-hmm. I do. Suddenly a loss for words, you know, doesn't know what to say. Suddenly feeling, and it could be because something that happened some time ago and this person comes in and they haven't changed. They haven't changed. They look fabulous. You see, this is the thing. So this person maybe is feeling insecure. They don't look good enough, because that's all also the energy. Yeah, feeling insecure. Maybe they, you know, they've gone through a lot of change here. Someone hasn't changed, though. This is the thing, at least the way they see it. We got to remember, people perceive and see us differently than we see ourselves. This is quite the read, but I'll tell you, this masculine is like, they mean business. Oh, yeah, they mean business. You're going to be shocked, and you're going to be, and this energy's, and this looks like this is something that's played out from some time ago, because it's a reflection on what happened and why something happened, finding out the truth, why someone walked away. Someone's shocked with what someone's telling them. And then I see this forgiveness and kindness, compassion, but this person still wants to come in. So I don't know what happened and why, but it's likely different for everyone. But that tower is that moment where someone has this massive realization. Yep, instant chemistry, the spark. This is often two people who just, something just doesn't get off the ground in the past. And then all of a sudden you're at the same place, the same time. There's some friends, people, some sort of social event, whether you all know each other or not. But I'll tell you, people noticed that two people looked at each other and the spark here. You betcha they did. I think somebody's feeling a little embarrassed. A little bit of embarrassment is what I feel. Yeah, but I feel we got a spark, major chemistry and attraction here. It's just like sudden. It's like this, yeah, look at that. See, it's an energy where the someone goes, the feelings are obviously mutual. They obviously feel the same. There's like everyone talking about it. I'm telling you. Yeah. So someone gonna come in, put that best foot forward. See, plant the seed, build it. See, it's an invitation to a home, planting the seed. So this is an energy of two people coming together here. See, someone's hopes and dreams, everything they could ever want. This is what someone's been searching for. Searching for. And this is someone saying, you know, ask them out. And now they're shy, lost for words. They don't know what to say. Yeah, look at that. They want to build something here. I tell you, they're working this out. They are working this out. And I see the feminine just focused on work. See, they want to know. Now, I don't know if it started because the feminine took the lead. And that's why I feel, Capricorn, you had that energy a while ago about being bold and taking the lead. So I wonder if you did, and you know, it hasn't completely played out yet. So, because I, like I say, it's just someone putting on the brakes, taking another look. Feeling differently after a period of time, seeing things in a whole different light, likely both of you. But this is crazy because I don't know if you offered somebody work or there was some sort of excuse, somebody made up some kind of excuse, something to do with work to start something here. Yeah, I don't know. It's all going to come out in the open though, but I don't think there's anything bad here at all, really. I mean, it's just about someone putting in the effort. See, this is someone who wants someone to put in the effort. Maybe this, there was a date and this person didn't put a lot of effort into it. And then someone's going, well, you know, with the tower, a little bit of a shock. What do you expect, right? Someone not paying them any attention. In fact, I think ignoring someone here. Yeah, if they want to come in, they need to come in right. They need to put in the effort because this is someone who's already put in some effort. See, they already took the risk. They already put in the effort. Now it's this person's turn. Yep. They gotta, I mean, you can see this energy of new. This is someone feeling really happy though, like really happy. This is what they've been looking for. And I wouldn't doubt for some of you, I'm seeing a lot of this, not for everyone by far. Someone waiting, holding a torch. So someone here's been waiting for a really long time, possibly. It doesn't have to be. It could be like this is, I remember this reading for you, Capricorn, like a few months ago or so, where you were in this bold energy. And I know it was planetary, about taking the lead, being bold, feminine or masculine. So pretty. And it's, I mean, we've got Emperor and Empress energy here, so. Is this situation going to come to fruition? It's just, I see a little more time coming. This person's working out the details of something here. That's somebody working on their home, working from home. It's someone learning about what someone does for a living, the things they do. But this masculine's also preparing themselves. You know, see, fixing up their home. But it's about putting in the effort because the feminine's already put in the effort. Yeah, this is someone going to just have to put themselves out there. And I do see happiness, happy home, happy life. This is a feminine is, and even the masculine, fantasizing about being together. It's coming to fruition here. I mean, you can take it or leave it. Yep, they're going to come in and speak truth. They're going to tell the truth. And they are honest, good moral, two people with really good morals, values. So really nice. So yeah. See, this is someone who has a little bit of regrets. They're going to tell you they kind of regret this. They kind of have a little bit of feel like there's not a lot of hope. It's something obviously, you know, they just regret it for whatever reason. I don't know. I don't see the reason. I mean, it's possible they were busy at work. Maybe they came across as a little cold and didn't really mean it. Yeah, it could be somebody was overwhelmed or really busy at the time. Whatever it is that happened, yeah. But like I say, it's about two people going to come together or someone had just come apart from someone. You know, the truth, they're going to speak the truth. And I feel it's not yet meant to be known. But I wouldn't be surprised if this is someone who has been holding a torch and kind of waiting for this to come to fruition. And it's going to happen. So let me grab Let's have a look. Tell me about the Three of Wands. Yeah, see, waiting for the Pentacle, for the offer, the opportunity. See, it's coming late. You see, it's coming late because it's over here. Building the foundation. Coming in right. Justice, making something right. See, justice is in your favor. You're about to get a reward for your hard work here, put it that way. Okay. Yeah. I like this reading. I think it's kind of exciting, and I do see some excitement, see, some passion, but this person kind of, like, they have some kind of regret here. They should, it's an energy of someone who probably should have just told the truth, or like I say, they were busy at work and they were a bit short. Could say it could be a lot of different things. Whatever it is, there's some kind of history between you, this person. But I feel, like I say, I feel they have regrets the way they conducted themselves. Yeah, see, they're single too, two single people. I think this person's shocked that you're single because they're looking at this person. Why are they single? Like, they want to know, why is this person single? And someone's saying, oh, maybe they just want to be single. This is often a person who just wants to be single, because I feel this is somebody who's had a lot of, the feminine, who's had a lot of disappointments in their love life. But it's a very capable person. Yeah, like, why? Why are they single? Like, what's wrong with them? You know, that's what I feel. So, But there's the King of Wands again, see? It's also the feminine energy with the King of Wands. This is a feminine picture of a King of Wands. So somebody very strong, very capable. Somebody, and even maybe, you know, physically strong too. Like somebody who's in good shape, you know, no matter their age. But look at that. See the Tower, shock, sudden. Is it telling you? This is going to be one of these very epic coming togethers when it happens. And I honestly can't see when, but you see happiness, emotional fulfillment. Somebody here definitely does want love. They do. But like I say, this is somebody who's had disappointments. And they're not someone who's taken risks before, possibly too, in the past, and never, you know, got rejected or ignored by someone. So this is someone who just focuses on other aspects of their life. Very balanced person. Yeah, see, it's a crush. Somebody who's actually longing for love. This is going to be simple. Like, once this ice is broken, and that's the thing, is breaking the ice between these two people. This is going to be very, very simple. There's going to be a little get-together. Someone here is probably planning something, a little get-together, reunion kind of thing. You know, let's get everyone together. There's going to be offers and invitations, phone calls, messages going out regard this. So I feel there's going to be someone helping two people come together. See, it's an energy of being patient. It's coming. 7 days, 7 weeks. See, 7 months. I don't think it's going to be too long, to be honest. Yeah, see, look at that, trying something different. So someone here just being patient, see, seeing things in a whole different light. They're planning, preparing. So someone preparing themselves, getting ready. And there's going to be maybe even a little gift. This is often somebody who will give someone a gift to show them they like them. It's an energy of breaking the ice. That's what I feel. It's going to be just breaking the ice. It's just going to be smashed to smithereens when these two people to come together. A lot of chemistry here. Big time. Yeah, see, there's the cup too. This is the feminine. You're going to get what you want. Okay, those of you who are feminine watching, those of you who are masculine, you know what you need to do. Because this is someone who needs to be, find it in themselves to become confident to reach out. Because this is someone who is not going to be, take another risk. Because this is something I feel that happened a while ago. And it's going to play out. I mean, I see it here. This person getting ready, just being patient, looking, planning very carefully, very meticulous, because it's an energy of wanting to impress. They're very impressed. This person's impressed with this feminine, but now they feel under pressure. They have to impress the other person, because this is someone who, you know, whatever they do is just very meticulous. Everything's just perfect. It's a perfectionist. So now they feel they have to, they have to kind of top it. There's a little King and Queen of Wands energy. Okay. for the King and Queen of Pentacles. Do you see? Being a little competitive. They have to try to impress. So it's going to take them a little time. You know, maybe to clean up their house, fix the things. I don't know. Preparing. So, yeah. But there it is. Take care. See you soon.